This episode of the Totally Rad Show is brought to you by Squarespace. Coming up, it's a new drama where Jason Isaacs is living in two worlds while he's awake.
All right, everybody, we are back in TV, finally talking about a pilot we've been anticipating for a while, actually.
Oh, yeah.
Awake, the new NBC crime drama, but that's not really what this show's about. It stars Jason Isaacs. It's created by Kyle Killen, who created Lone Star. It follows, Jason Isaacs' character is a father and a husband who, at the beginning of the show, is in a car crash. And where it starts to get a little sketchy is that, let's say, we'll just start here, his son dies in the car crash, and he's dealing with that. That's why I said, let's start here.
Okay.
He's dealing with the loss of his son and his job and how that's all working and his relationship with his wife. Then he goes to sleep, and when he wakes up, his wife is the one who died in the car crash, and his son is alive, and now he's dealing with all different people involved in his life around that. So it's basically a guy who is living two different lives concurrently, one in which his son died in this car crash and one in which his wife died in this car crash. And he is trying to stay sane if you could possibly in that situation. So Daniel Trachtenberg,
yeah,
Awake. Were you awake?
I was wide awake.
Are you awake now?
I loved it. The only bummer is that they aired the trailer for it way back. We talked about it.
Yeah, pre-whatever.
It was at the pilot. Showed the whole, all the surprises, you know, like all the, like, it showed the whole episode.
So you're saying it's a trailer?
No, it was one of those pilot preview things that we watched. That was a bummer. That was a bummer because this pilot, it can
chock full of twists.
Yeah, and like that contained everything in here. But power to the show, power to the premise. It was still freaking delicious and awesome. The Jason Isaacs is great. The acting's great. Okay, whatever. But the way that science fiction idea is carried out, because it's not, it's more than that. Like that someone could have made that show. It's kind of like Lost. Like it could have been just a show where people are on an island.
Yeah.
But there's these other things happening that are like, oh shit, that's happening. And so him seeing his therapist in both realities and the way those interactions are played out, and there's just so many the crime solving aspects. I actually enjoyed the crimes. Like, I thought they were unique. You know, sometimes when I watch the Monster of the Week,
the procedurals,
yeah. I'm not as thrilled by the crimes.
Yeah.
I was actually thrilled by the criminal and the crimes here and how they were dealt with. There was no, like, in the Grim Pilot listening to the iPod, you know, whatever, right? It was actually cool on its own. But then the way that they interacted, so many awesome, it's a science fiction show. It's like, that's what's cool. It doesn't look like a science fiction show, but it is a science fiction show.
Which is what Lost did so well. It didn't smell like a science fiction show.
Right.
So, you know, the moms in line at the Starbucks were like, dude, who do you like, Jack or whatever?
And a good looking pilot, David Slade, put his stamp on it. He did, he looks like he sort of set up the series. But anyway, he's a cool commercial.
Yeah, that's what they usually the directors of pilots try to do.
Yeah, he's an EP as well, so that's what I was.
Got it. Yeah, I did want to talk to you about the way it was shot because I felt like it wasn't shot like traditional TV that we usually see.
A lot of cameras over here. Whoop! Cameras over here.
Yeah.
Well, it makes sense. Cameras over there. That was.
Hey, what side of his process he was
on?
Yeah. Jeff, what'd you think?
Delicious premise, as you say. Really, really, you just hear
this
premise.
It's like succulent crab legs.
You go that, it's magnificent. It's really a tantalizing concept of like, my God, putting a character in that situation is excruciating.
Yeah. And the elevator pitch, you get that.
You get that. You get the drama of that in just in the concept.
Yeah.
And it is well executed. I disagree with Dan in the sense of the crime procedural part. And I have a feeling I'm going to disagree with you as well on that, because I think that's where the show lost a little of its luster for me. I think what's so interesting is his interactions with his family and him dealing with this and all those scenes with the two different psychiatrists and the fact, or psychologists, I guess they're psychiatrists.
Depends upon where they got their degree or what they got it
in. How much more school they went to.
Well, just the idea of having them be different doctors was brilliant, and I feel like somebody coming up with that. Because the concept isn't necessarily that he's living two completely different lives, but the fact that they went there with that is smart.
And he's self-aware.
Right.
Yeah. It's not, like, you could interpret that premise as, oh, he doesn't even, you know.
He doesn't even know what's happening. We're just watching.
But he's not, But no, his.
Yeah. And him trying to piece together which one is the real world and which one is the dream world. And am I a butterfly dreaming of a human or am I human dreaming of a butterfly? Yeah. It's wonderful. Yeah. And I love being in that. It's a hard show to watch in a lot of ways because it's really about loss and that's a hard thing.
Yeah.
And I wanted the show to be more about that. It's somber for a large portion of it. And then it sort of like indulges in the fact that well, we need to be a television show now, so let's give you this action-packed kind of crime moments that I just wasn't really interested in, and I didn't think played out in a very compelling way. I thought the action moments were really kind of clunky, like pulling that girl out of the window, and just every time a gun is fired in the show, it just feels really kind of clunky and not well executed, and really not what I'm interested in. I just was so much more interested in his human drama, and I loved to the first third of the show how willing they were to stay in that somber place and really be a human drama rather than sort of a, hey, we know you have short attention span, so we gotta do something upbeat and fast-paced now. And then it sort of kind of goes there toward the end. But I like the show quite a lot. I think the performances are strong, and I think the show feels significant and weighty, and there's something happening there that's interesting.
Yeah, I think by far this is the best of the new shows that I've seen all year, and maybe one of my favorite shows in the last 5 years. Really connected with this pilot, and for me, it lived up to what I was hoping this show was going to be about, which is about this man who's sort of doesn't, you know, I mean, the best thing is that this guy's not an emotional being to begin with. So to then put him in a situation where he's got to deal with, you know, this son without a wife, but he's, you know, this gruff cop guy who's sort of not the best father probably before this experience and dealing with that. But then also on the flip side being the sort of stoic guy dealing with this wife who's lost her own child as well. You know what I mean? And it's a really great pull, and I love that the two psychiatrists are unbelievable. I can't remember what the Asian guy's name from SVU. BD Wong. Love BD Wong. He is amazing. He should always play psychiatrists because he was a psychiatrist on SVU, and he's amazing as that character. He's just so empathetic and intellectual. It's great.
He was watching our show and he was like, oh, well, that's really nice. Oh, okay, I'm tired.
It's not as, I told them, but I didn't. I started watching The Sopranos and falling in love with Sopranos. The psychiatrist situation in there is one of the most realistic.
Yeah.
I was already watching it, though, wasn't it? When we had...
Oh, Jeff.
Oh, Jeffrey.
$10.
but
you should probably slip that on the...
It's like, to the show's credit, it's not the most realistic depiction. It's very much for the plot.
Correct.
But you need...
It's great.
You got it. I mean, you got to have some explanation of...
Yeah, that's what the other psychiatrist said.
Yeah.
Amazing. So, and as far as
Sherry Jones is the one who plays the other one who's awesome.
Yeah, both amazing. Yeah. And as far as the procedural stuff, I mean, for me, it didn't feel like I was getting procedural for procedural's sake, like some of the other pilots that we got. For me, it felt like this guy's a cop. This guy does this as a job. Obviously. And not only that, now you're starting to see where the two realities are actually kind of going over into this weird mix of information that he may or may not have picked up at different places. And I'm very interested to see what I hope it's not that everybody died in the car crash, people who wrote that show, because I would stab somebody in the face. But I'm very interested to see as we get farther along, where this mesh happens, I mean, you can smell.
I didn't think about
you can
that.
Smell That's a relationship.
Yeah, no. I love the.
You can smell a relationship between the tennis coach and him.
For sure.
Which is where you go
and
to bed and you're married. You go and then you wake up and you're banging this.
It's like the best
tennis.
Thing that could possibly happen.
I know, but now know, what? Where does that
such
happen?
An interesting. When that started happening, I was like, oh my god,
what's so gonna
many
happen?
But see, that's where the show is interesting. The most interesting is because you have a guy who is dealing with grief where he gets to see everybody.
Yeah.
He doesn't have grief, but everybody else in his life does.
Well, and that's the thing where he's trying to convince the wife about what's been happening, and she's like, don't stop talking about that stuff.
And then that last scene where she asked him to tell the boy something, it's beautiful and almost made me cry. And that's where the show really shines. I just don't care about all the other action-y stuff.
But that's his job.
I mean, things will be interwoven.
I feel like that's where a series lives is in that week to weakness.
Look at season one of Justified. It had all of those things that I didn't like, but I didn't even like any of it. But eventually, I mean, you know.
I think there's an amazing.
You may start to hate it.
I think there's
a pilot.
I think there's an amazing TV series here to be found.
Wait, I should say, and the partner, what happens with the partner in the two realities.
Yeah.
Conceptually was like, oh my god, there's just so many philosophical ramifications.
It's juicy. It's a juicy show.
It's
definitely
worth
a watch. It's on tonight. It's a must watch for anybody who has any interest in anything awesome. And then see what happens. I mean, we're going to follow the series. We're going to see how it goes. This is definitely one that's getting onto my TiVo record series season.
And
I will enjoy watching it. So check it out tonight, I think 10 p.m.
Hopefully they
Pacific
watched
Standard
already
Time,
and then watched us talk about it.
Watch. Pause when we started. All right, everybody, be sure to stick around. We're going to be answering one of your Twitter questions right after this. But first, we want to thank our sponsor. Squarespace.com is a fast and easy way to create a high-quality blog, portfolio, or website. It's fully hosted, takes care of all the tricky details of getting your site online. There's nothing to download. There's nothing to install, nothing to set up. You just click it, and it's happening. Plus, Squarespace sites come with a variety of page types, from blogs to galleries. They have all sorts of social widgets, integration for Twitter, Flickr, all kinds of crazy stuff. They even have an iPhone, an iPad, and Android app allow you to create blog stuff on the go, edit posts,
really cool,
manage your comments, view your statistics, all sorts of crazy stuff. They have an amazing 24-hour support, super fast response. Plus, they have 13 template designs and 85 new styles, which is a lot of new styles. Two brand new templates that just came out very recently. 300 plus new fonts added, so you can do all this kind of stuff online, anywhere you are. New CSS editors for those who like to get in there and code. I mean,
can I do a whole website just in Wingdings?
You can. Nobody will understand it, but you can do it. They also recently launched the live online workshop, so you can actually sit down and take live online workshops to get yourself started at Squarespace.com.
Cool.
This is the best place to do anything, period, end of story, especially cooking. For 15% off the next 6 months, enter the coupon code TRS3. See you later.
Tomorrow, we've got our review of the movie Project X.
Today's Twitter question comes to us from Patrick McChrystal at P_MCC. If you could live anywhere at any time in history and be any profession you want, who, what, and where would you be? And this is a twist. We get a lot of like, where would you want, when would you want to live? But this is a twist because
profession.
Now it's what profession would you want?
Jeff would be a playwright in like Shakespearean times. Or an actor.
Or an actor.
That's pretty good. I actually was going to go with king. Because it's good to be the king.
It's not a profession. It's a.
That's a born-in monarchy. Yeah. It's not a job. It's a profession.
I like your answer for me.
I think it'd be an alchemist.
Interesting.
Really?
You're so good.
Alchemist doesn't mean so magician. Alchemist is basically the pharmacist of the Middle Ages.
I'd be a wizard.
You'd be leeching.
Oh, okay, that's bad. Can't be a king because that's not a profession. He can be a wizard.
I'd be Merlin.
I would be
a court jester.
I'd be a ranger.
I like how we're all in the Middle Ages.
I know. I guess
you could go anywhere. You could be a cowboy. You could be.
You know what? I'm a bootlegger in the prohibitionist.
Like, here you go.
That era is brutal.
Oh, and the Middle Ages is not brutal.
But
Middle Ages is brutal.
It's not really a fun occupation in the
They don't have soap. in the Middle Ages?
I'd be a caveman. And be pretty good, my job actually. Would be
hunting.
Hunting and gathering.
Amazing. Thank you, Patrick McChrystal.
You're the future.
No.
I want to be the hive mind.
I want to be the queen of the hive mind.
I'll be the king of the hive mind.
There's no king. The king gets eaten after
you guys
sex.
Are married.
I ate him after we had sex.